Hello, welcome back to my channel. Okay, so today I'm filming my Makeup Empties video, but before I do that, I wanted to clarify something I said yesterday. I filmed my Sephora haul, and I said that the Tom Ford cream powder shadow likely changed the way it was packaged. They didn't. I just lost my mind for a minute. It's exactly the same. It's totally my bad. I don't know. It's a little concerning, frankly, to use something every day and not know exactly what it looks like, but I'm just gonna blame my lack of optimum caffeine levels for that one. Tom Ford, as expected, flawless. I feel like I need to kind of give a little bit of a prologue to this because you'll see it here in a minute, but like a lot of this is just multiples of the same products because I know what I like, I know it works on me, I know it works on my clients, I know it works in environmental stuff, so I'm probably gonna do what I did in the skincare video where I kind of talk about why I like things and brands and that kind of stuff, or like why I have so many of whatever. But the majority of this stuff is for my face. It's like what I wear. The educator in me has a desire to like tell you about a lot of things. The attention span reality check in me is like, don't do that. So I'm just gonna kind of start with, if you have questions, just ask me. I'm happy to answer them. Leave me a comment. I'm on Instagram and all that shit, so just, you know, hit me up. I'm happy to answer your questions. But I don't want to make like a 75-minute long thing about, you know, complexion and lighting and all that kind of crap. So anyway, here we go. For a very long time, I used the Perricone No Foundation Foundation Serum as my primer. I have three, and then I have a little one. The way I use this was I would basically use it after my moisturizer, and then as a primer, and then I would just put concealer over top of it. So I really didn't use foundation because this does have coverage. It's obvious it's a foundation serum. I'm kind of consciously taking a break from it because I was using it so frequently that I just wanted to try other stuff out. But I will always love this. I will very likely repurchase it and go back to it. It's not for everybody. I'll be totally candid with you. It has a tint to it, so if you're not in this color range or like basically, you know, light skinned, you can't wear it. So that's a huge suck factor. However, if you do match this or like are close enough to it, because it's not super pigmented, so you're not getting like, you know, full coverage foundation or anything out of this. But what's awesome about it is A, it has your SPF in it, so it's got a broad spectrum SPF 30. B, it has neuropeptides in it. So basically what that means is it tells the contours of your face to stay there. So you're doing like a treatment every time you're wearing it. And C, it's so lightweight. So, you know, if you live in a hotter climate, if you don't like to wear makeup, if anything where you're just like, you don't actually like to feel anything on your skin, this is a really great option for you. And it's skincare. It's Perricone skincare. Honestly, I cannot speak highly enough about this product. I clearly love it. I've had several of them and I will absolutely go back to it. I felt like I needed to do some more research and explore what other new stuff was out there, just because I've been really into this guy and really devoted to him for a long time. So yeah, love this product. Okay, so next up I've got some concealers. I have three of these. It's the Sephora Collection, the Bright Future Gel Serum Concealer. You'll notice I like serums because they're really thin. I like skin to look like skin. Even with my clients, I will very candidly admit that I don't like Instagram makeup in real life. It looks great in professional lighting. It looks great on photo shoots and that kind of thing. But in everyday life, I mean, it's a lot to look at. And I kind of, in my, you know, in what I do, one of the things that I kind of cater to is making you look like you. And by no means am I bashing. Do whatever you want. Makeup is about self-expression. Be confident. Do you, boo. I don't care. But in terms of how I do makeup and like what I like skin to look like, I like it to look like skin. This is a beautiful concealer if you like that, because it mimics skin texture really nicely. It's thin, it's brightening. I mean, when it first came out, I remember we couldn't keep it in stock. It was just like, there's like 23 shades and there would be like four. Like literally four of these just like randomly. People just freaked out for it. It's like really inexpensive and it's awesome. Sephora Collection is a really great line if you're not terribly familiar with it. Sephora is owned by Louis Vuitton Moët Hennessy. So Louis Vuitton does not make makeup because of Sephora Collection. So they technically own it in their repertoire. So it's made to the same luxury standards as, you know, every other luxury makeup brand. Sephora Collection's made to those standards, but because they're like an in-house brand, they don't have the price point on them, but they also, their design and the actual aesthetic of the product is much more minimalistic. So you're not gonna get like, you know, your leather lipstick case or, you know, whatever. So that's kind of what I tell people is you're not paying for packaging. And you're not paying for marketing or middlemans or any of that stuff because it's Sephora. But that doesn't mean their products are bad. They make literally some of my favorite products are Sephora Collection. The concealers, the lip stains are incredible. So if you're in the market for a lightweight, really good coverage concealer, and you like that gel serum consistency, I'm such a sucker for it. It's so good. When that serum concealer trend came out, I was so happy because it really does change the way your skin looks. Your skin just looks more natural. It's beautiful. It's the opposite of like slapping on all those, you know, again, I'm not saying anything's wrong with it, but like if you don't want to do that, these were made for you. So love. Another concealer, one that I personally will always love, it's such a great one, is the Laura Mercier Secret Camouflage Concealer. I have mine in SC5. This is a cult product and it's the gold standard for a reason. It is such a phenomenal concealer, especially if you know how to use it. This is a super versatile concealer. You can use it for color correcting. You can use it for, like, depending on which one you get, because that second tone in there. It's really great if you have, like, really pronounced darkness under the eyes because of those two tones. You can really color correct that more naturally. Especially if you're like intimidated by the idea of color correcting, it's like a baby step into it, right? It's like a kind of like a kiddie pool version of it, but it's still really effective. It photographs really beautifully. Laura Mercier kind of generally is one of my go-to brands for complexion because she really understands complexion. You'll notice I have a shit ton of Laura Mercier. I love her complexion products. She just kills it. Her actual approach to skin, I really am a fan of. Similarly to NARS, I'm such a fan of how NARS approaches skin and they want it to look like skin. It gets me. I love. Okay, so I hope that made sense. People love this. It wins awards like every day. Like it's great for a reason. If you've never tried it, try it. It's kind of intimidating to look at because it's a drier concealer. It's not super wet. It's not super emollient. So you do need to kind of spread it, or you do need to, if you have like a really wet foundation on, it'll get some spread from that, but play around with it. If you are super struggling with that, use your fingers because the heat of your hand will melt the product down and you'll really get some spread out of it that way. But you don't need a lot. You can build it up. You can use this all over your face as foundation if you really want like a lot of coverage, but it doesn't necessarily look like a lot of coverage. Ugh, I love it. Okay, next I'm gonna talk about powder. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have five of them. This is the Laura Mercier Smooth Finish Foundation Powder. I'm gonna use one that is not shattered. This is my only powder that I buy. Clearly. I just wanna put them away though, because they're kinda messy. I have a love-hate relationship with this powder, but the love will consistently win out, as evidenced by the fact that I have five of them. This powder is amazing if you are, if you have skin like I do, where your combination, like straight up combo, there's no normal, you're oily or dry, like your face kind of just eats makeup, and you need to, if it's like getting patchy or if you need to touch up or whatever. If you like that, you know, if you just need a good, like, fix me powder. I need it to have enough coverage to, like, fix it if I need to. But I also like the idea of, you know, I want to have the option to, like, just lightly press it on just to kind of smooth something out, if that makes sense. The other thing I really like about this is it makes your skin just look really creamy and pretty. So if you're ever having one of those days where you're just like into the idea of having Barbie skin, this could still give it to you. I love that I have that range with this. The only criticism that I have towards this powder is that when you're using it and you're running out of it, it tends to like really crumble on itself, and like every single one I have that has died a really messy death. Like, it's just everywhere. Your makeup bag looks like a bomb went off. Like, that's my only kind of gripe with it. But I feel like, I mean, that's just kind of everybody's gripe with powder in general, so you can't really hold that against this. And the formula is so great that I haven't found anything else that I like and that wears as well as this does, that really caters to my skin's texture and the range that could potentially be. But I just love this. I think it's a really good one. Smooth finish. Foundation itself was created, like the liquid foundation was created for climates like Austin. So I would assume the powder was as well. But I have worn it in many climates and I've been totally fine. Like, I don't find that it exacerbates any of your skin texture issues or your skin concerns. So that's a nice perk. And then the other thing I would say is, if you do find yourself, if you do get flaky ever, if you're healing, if you have a dry spot, whatever, what I typically tell people is keep something small in your bag, like a moisturizer, beauty elixir, Bicotyl, like whatever it is, like some kind of spray, or some kind of rehydrator, right? That Evian, there's a million options for you. Spray that, let that kind of get like to re-moisten the area, and then go back over with your powder just to kind of smooth it out. That way it doesn't cling to the flake, because powder inevitably will do that. That's what its job is. So that way it has like a more of a smoother texture to it. So just as a thing with you, if that's like a point of contention with you with powder, add something else to your touch-up routine so you don't have that issue, or to minimize that issue if nothing else. Because no powder is going to do that. And if it does, there's some kind of negative effect later. It'll slip. It'll look shiny. It can look a different color, the whole thing. Okay, so bronzer. 1, 2. I swear to God, this video is not sponsored. I wish it was. 3, 4, 5. I have 5 bronzers, all the same shade. This is Bronzer 2 by Laura Mercier. Remember when I told you that doesn't last as long as Guerlain? Clearly. This bronzer is beautiful. It's super versatile. It's matte, but it's not ruddy. It's buildable. It never looks streaky or gritty or grimy or shiny or like any. I cannot even tell you how many bronzers I've played with. I can't even tell you how many that I've tested and then I've, you know, tried to make work and everything. And this, the formula is just heaven on this. The color range is really good. They have 3 or 4 different colors, but it's just a really, the actual formula is spot on. It's so good. My only criticism is you, at least if you're like me and you're really liberal with your bronzer, you go through a lot of it. I don't contour my face, I just use bronzer, so that may be why, but just if you're like me and you do that, just as a heads up, you're gonna buy these more often than you'd like to. But it's so good. I don't even look at other bronzers. This guy, the Guerlain bronzers, are my go-tos. And I'll show you. I mean, you can't really tell, but like that's what the pan looks like. They're all empty, so you can't really see a whole lot of color. But yeah, it's so good. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and a mini of the Laura Mercier loose setting powder, the translucent. And then I have a dead puff. I know setting powders are like new companies are making them, or like companies are coming out with new ones and whatever, right? I know people have their preferences. Some people really love some people really love others. I will always be in camp Laura Mercier translucent setting powder. I love this puff. I love that you can really get into the corners of your face. If you're doing somebody's makeup and you're doing a lip, if you're touching their face, I like to keep this around my fingers just to keep A, my hands off their face, but B, to keep the warmth of my hand from transferring makeup off their face and me having to go back in and patch it up. So this is lovely for that. And it loops over my fingers really nicely, which I just like. And you can, you know, do the rolling motion. There's just a lot. I just love hers. And they age really well. They like kind of, I don't know. I just feel like one with this when I use it. Like it just is very intuitive to me. I like it a lot. Laura Mercier powder. It has a specific texture which actually works in your favor because it smooths out your texture and it just looks really silky and clean and fresh and matte. But it doesn't look dead or flat, if that makes sense. It photographs beautifully. There isn't a flashback, which is, you know, a big deal because a lot of people get kind of confused about flashbacks and what causes them. So you don't get one with that. It's also kind of a nice autocorrect. So if you are doing your makeup and you do something wrong and you're like, oh my God, how do I fix this? That powder will save you sometimes because it really does just kind of help blend everything and blur everything, and depending how you use it, it doesn't have just like one function. It can be pretty multitasking. I've used it even to like set underneath the eyebrow if you don't want an actual color for like a very natural look. I use it just to kind of mattify that and get that really clean. You can't tell what it is, but it just looks really clean. It is nice to carve out a brow with. It sort of like always works. And it's never fussy. The only thing that sucks about it is traveling with a full size one is a nightmare. But I will totally take that burden on to continue to use that powder. I also have the Laura Secret Brightening Powder. I was using this underneath my eyes for a while. It's literally ground cashmere. So if you like the idea of like ground cashmere on your face, so that really luxe idea, you'll love this. I will say it can look bright. Obviously it's a brightening powder. It can look overly bright if you are too liberal with it. And you'll see that in photos. So what I do tell people to do is cut it with something else. If you like really want to bake, I don't bake with that one. Bake with the setting powder and then go over it with the brightening powder and then kind of dust it off. Play around with it, but like, just be mindful of the fact that you will get that whiteness underneath the eye if you go too crazy with it. Please don't bake with that though. Okay, so I have NARS blush in Orgasm. I don't think I use blushes by any other brand, really. I really love the NARS blush formula. It's like my favorite blush formula ever. Orgasm is universally flattering. Works as a beautiful highlight on darker skin tones. I mean, it's a cult product. Everybody and their brother's heard of it. It's amazing. I can't rave highly enough about it. I used to work for NARS. I love NARS. Okay. I have the Naked Urban Decay Flushed Palette. I had the bronzer. Clearly, I just gave up. I had the bronzer from this one. This is good. I don't like this palette. I wouldn't buy it. Just because I don't like how there isn't, like, a clear line indicator. Like, there's no kind of separation. So you get these weird, like, blends of product. And I don't want my products to blend when I apply them directly. I want them to blend because I've blended them. So you just get kind of like unusable sections and that pisses me off, right? So I would not buy this. And if you don't mind having those lines, then go for it because it's a good product. It just bothers me. Lips, I have the, I was really sad about this. I have Eros by NARS lip lacquers, little lip pots. I love these. These were like, and this color was so perfect. It was gorgeous. Oh shit. Anyway, they're just old and dried out, and it was just starting to smell, and I don't want to throw it away because of it's such like a sentimental product to me, which I can see would be weird for some people, but like I have some products that just, I think everybody maybe has this, but like for me, I have really specific products that just meant something, and the NARS lip paints are one of them. I just love them. Okay, so then I have a Tarte Lip Surgeons, the Intuitive Lip Gloss. This is awesome. Like, I was shocked by how much I liked this lip gloss. I don't like the packaging at all, which is why for the longest time I was like, ugh, whatever. It has the technology to like, you know, be intuitive to your lip. So like the Smashbox O Gloss and tint. It's like a similar product to that. What I personally really like doing with it is putting on a lip liner and then putting this on, because it still does get intuitive, but it does change because of the lip liner. And I've always loved how it turned out, and I've used it with probably like 6 or 7 different lip liners, and I'm always pleased with it. So I have probably gone through 3 of these, which is impressive for me, because I'm not a big lip gloss person. I have a lot, but I don't consistently reach for them. This one I was like, I love, especially like summertime and stuff. You want a lip, but you don't want the maintenance of like multiple products. This is just a good, like, always works. You don't have to think about it. Run out the door. It's a little bit of polish. You can go to the gym in it. It's great. The Tarte's a really cool line. It's good. I've got a lot of mascara. I have Benefit Roller Lash x3 and Benefit They're Real x1. They're Real is an amazing mascara. I love it on other people. I don't love it on myself. If you do not wear false lashes, this brush is your, like, saving grace, because it has those tips at the top, so you can really get into the little hairs around your eyes, around your lower lashes. You can really, really build them up. This is, like, such a great mascara if you don't like to wear falsies. It's also a really good one to wear by itself. So if you don't like the idea of cocktailing mascara or wardrobing mascara, you just want one and you can build it up and really have like crazy lashes, this is a really good one. My personal favorite mascara of all time is the Benefit Roller Lash. The brush is that hook and roll, like old school Velcro rollers, like our moms and grandmas had. Personally, I wear falsies every day, so helps me comb through my lashes, helps me get them dark, because I'm blonde, so they're blonde as well. I think it's real, like, winning point with me though is of how it does my lower lashes, because they build up really nicely. I don't transfer. It really does get the length. That hook and roll on your lower lashes really helps you articulate the full length of that lower lash. I never get staining underneath my eyelid. I never get transfer. I don't get any weird black dots. Everything I want out of a mascara, this gives me every day. Love it. Like, it's just the best. It's so easy. It always works. That's my thing. If there's like one thing that you can kind of garner from this video, is that I buy the same stuff once I find something that works, most of the time. And I have to consciously tell myself, like, okay, no, you have to start trying other stuff, because otherwise you're like, I can't not know about something. It's my job. So, you know, I have to force myself to like try other things. But I have favorites for sure, and this is definitely my favorite mascara. I have 5 of the dark eyelash glue by House of Lashes and 1 of the light. Obviously, this is my favorite lash glue. It's non-irritating. It's super sturdy. It's really easy to use. It's black, which is awesome. I love House of Lashes. They're my favorite lash line. I buy all my lashes through them. I do love a lash company that gives a pro discount, and they do that. So that's really great. But they make the best lash glue I've ever used in my life. I love it. And it dries quickly, and it's just, ugh. It doesn't have that weird goopiness. There's none of that. It's got a brush tip to it. It's awesome. Okay. Oh, another concealer is the Paracone No Concealer Concealer. This is a nice one. I did like this a lot. I've had a couple of them. If you want skincare in your concealer, it's got it. It is very much like a lesser, if you like less makeup. I love Paracone's No Makeup Makeup for people who want, you know, a complexion without like the work of it. It's a really good option. I have a Sephora Collection Contour Rouge Gel Lip Liner. This was in Wino. Oh, this is the dark one. I like this lip liner a lot. It's, A, it's really cheap, but B, I wear lip liner like every day. I have, like, if I don't have lip liner on, I like don't look like I have a mouth. It's so weird. My top lip is a little bit more pronounced than my bottom lip in terms of my lip line. So right around like the edges of my lips, I don't have like a strong lift to my lip, if you know what I mean. Like, this just goes right into my like chin. So I need a lip liner that's not gonna bleed. It did a good job, and it was really affordable. So I like that a lot. Last concealer I've got is Makeup Forever, the Ultra HD. I really liked this one. They came out with this and the color correcting ones at the same time, and I had one of each, and I really did like them. They're great. Also, if you get a beauty blender, you can really do a nice lighter version. I mean, you could go full heavy too, but like if you don't want to, you can really sculpt your face out and still make it look like skin. Really well with this. It's so pigmented that you use just the slightest amount and you can really get good coverage out of it, like a lot of coverage out of it. So what I tell people to do is use the smallest amount you can and then take a beauty blender to it and you can really diffuse it and make it look like skin. So you still get a sculpted face, but like the weight of it, if that makes sense. Okay, next, I have three of the Kat Von D tattoo liners in Trooper. I cannot, for the life of me, love another eyeliner the way I love this. I can't speak highly enough about it. It's so easy. It's so user-friendly. It always delivers. It's just the best. It's just the best. There's just no better. Stila's Stay All Day is the number one seller at Sephora. This is actually number two. And Stay All Day, fine. I get it. I do get it. I think the kind of difference between the two is how you use your eyeliner, because the people who like Stila love Stila. Like, it's like a cult thing. Like, if you're in the camp Stila, that's what you use. If you're in camp Kat Von D, that's what you use. And I get that. So I think it kind of comes down to what are you more comfortable with, because they are different. This is a little thicker than the Stila one is, and the tip is different. So I tell people, like, go in and like play with them and see which one feels better in your hand, because they both do stay on a long time. I don't like the Stay All Day as much as this one. I will always love this more. This is just my favorite. Kat does such a good job on her line. You can tell she really is super passionate about it too, and I really love people who get really into it, and there is such an artfulness to it, and there's such a, you can tell it's personal for her. I really respond to that. So she just makes me happy. Okay, so brow products and then we done. I have many. I have the Smashbox, the Brow Tech Matte Pencil and Taupe. This was given to me at Sephora. I don't even remember this. So I obviously did not rebuy it. It might have broken off. I don't know. It has that tip that I don't like. It has the actual, like, the automatic thing, and typically those, the way this is shaped, I am almost positive this just broke on me. So I'm always like really like when I see this, I'm like, yeah, this is gonna work for like 3 days and then the whole product's gonna fall off and I'm pissed. So I don't remember it. That's telling me something. I have two of the Kevin Aucoin the Precision, I almost said that in French, the Precision Brow Pencil and Warm Blonde. I loved this brow pencil. I actually kept one, and I used the spoolie to do my brows still, because it was so good. The Warm Blonde I really loved, because if you're like me and you're a warm blonde, it is really hard to find the type of color you want for your brows, and I really appreciated that. And I mean, like, Kevin Aucoin, I remember him. Like, I remember when he was alive, and I remember thinking he was, and I still do, he was just this force. Like, he was so incredible with how he looked at faces and how he taught. I just love him. And how he explained product and how he made product and what he looked at. Like, you can really tell. First and foremost, he was a makeup artist, and he looked at faces, and he looked at skin tone, and he looked at how things were going to react, and, you know, well, you're this skin tone, so you need to be this, or this is your hair color, all that stuff. You see it everywhere in his line, and as a makeup artist, I just so deeply appreciate that, and I think we're all so lucky to have had him, because he just, like, to me, before the Kardashians, he was it. Like, he was the Mario Dedovanovic. Like, he was the OG, right? Like, there's just, holy shit. He was the first famous makeup artist I had ever heard of. You know, like, before, oh, like, he was a celebrity. I just thought he was, like, so revolutionary. And I still do. I have all of his books. I love him. I just am, oh. So anyway, of course I love his brow. His line really looks at how everything works together harmoniously and the look and everything. This is a really great brow pencil if you're looking for a new one. I loved it. I really did. I had, before that one, I had the Anastasia Brow Wizzes in Caramel. If you ever watch my old videos, you know I just burned through these suckers. Which is why I actually went to the Kevin Kwan, because I wanted something to last longer for me. So I gave these up for the Kevin Kwan, and then we stopped selling that one in my store. I was ordering it online, and then Benefit came out with their brow products and just changed my life. So my favorite brow pencil is the Kevin Kwan Precision Brow. My favorite non-pencil brow product is the Benefit Cabrow. This is what I use. This is in shade 3, which is what I have on today. I really like this because I do not like the Anastasia Pomade, the dip brow, because on my hair, I have really coarse hair, and my eyebrows are blonde, so you don't see much of them, but they are coarse, and you could really see the texture difference between the product and my hair, so I could never use the dip brow. And this, it's a different type. It's a cream gel. It really does such a good job with the actual like brow hair texture. So regardless of what your texture is, if you have no eyebrows, if you have very fine eyebrows, if you have coarse eyebrows, what have you, this works with that. And I don't know what the formula with the cream gel specifically is, but they nailed it when they made Cabrow. And I also really appreciate that there are 6 colors. And I have always found a match for people. And I mean, like, I am a pretty pale, warm blonde, and 3 is my color because the other 2 were too cool toned to match me. So, yeah, love that brow product. So anyway, that's my makeup empties for a year, probably a little over a year, actually. Almost all of that was on my face, too. Some of the powders I took from my kit, some of the Laura powders, and some of the lash glues came from my kit. But other than that, pretty much everything else is on my face. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them. I'm happy to answer them for you. And until next time, I'll see you later. Bye!